And we're just about to get going with the keynotes. First up is David Cullimore. David has got a great story to tell. He's a young man, as you'll see, and he wanted to be a race car designer. So many people do. But he didn't have the math grades to get into engineering school, so he became an industrial designer. But he's got a great story to tell you about how he got from there to here. So David, please come on up. Looking forward to this, David. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So yes, my name is David Cullimore. I'm 23 years old, and I'm a design engineer at a company called Prodrive. Now, what do Prodrive do? Prodrive encompasses what could be thought of as four separate companies. Firstly, Composites, Advanced Technologies, Brandand, which is a merchandising business, and Motorsport, which is what they're most famous for, through the Subaru World Rally Team and the Aston Martin Racing Team. So I'm a design engineer, and I'm working on the Aston Martin Vantage replacement that we used in GT series racing. But what I'm here today to talk about is my journey from student to professional, how I got to where I am today. And I'll start by saying that as I was growing up, I always liked making things. I was always building projects. And it seemed natural that I was going to become an engineer, a design engineer. However, the UK school and university system is particularly tailored towards academic high flyers, of which I wasn't one of. I failed to gain the maths and physics entry requirements to study engineering at a UK university. I was prohibited from studying engineering at university, so I had to find an alternative strategy. So I chose industrial design, as it's a course that is similar to engineering, had many transferable skills like CAD, but ultimately it didn't require a maths grade to enter. I, this year, in 2016, graduated from Loughborough University with a first class degree. But I had to find another way to fulfill my passion for engineering, which is why I discovered Greenpower. Now, what is Greenpower? Greenpower is an educational charity set up in 1999 with the aim of inspiring young engineers. And they do this by hosting a series of electric car racing for schools. The format is a design, build, and race challenge. Design a car to a set of sporting and technical regulations. Build it using a standard motor and battery so that every car starts with the same amount of power. And race together, real time, at some of the UK's most well-known circuits. The winner is the car that crosses the line first after a set period of time. There are three age categories in Greenpower, ranging from 9 years old to 25. And one of the best things about Greenpower is the ability to compete right through education into your professional career. The first two categories are aimed at schools and colleges. But the top category is also open to universities and corporate teams, like Jaguar Land Rover and Lockheed Martin, just to name two. They use Greenpower as a development tool for their apprentices, graduates, and new starters. So what is unique about Greenpower? Why does Greenpower work as an educational tool? Greenpower is a project-based learning scheme, which is far more fun and engaging for students because they're able to apply what they learn in the classroom in a practical manner. It exposes students at a young age to many different disciplines, and it allows them to make their own minds up rather than having preconceived notions. But it's not all about engineering. There's many different skills like teamworking, logistics, finance. There'll be something for every student in Greenpower. Now, my Greenpower journey started at school, but I was 17 at the time, in my last year before university, and I missed out on the large proportion of doing Greenpower, which is a regret of mine. I was part of a team. We designed, built and raced a car, but at the end of the year, I still felt that there was more for me to learn in green power. So I, in 2012, set up Cullimore Racing as an independent team. And by independent, I mean that I wouldn't be associated with a school, college, or corporate team, and that I would design and build a car and race with the help of my friends and family. However, before I could start building my car, I had to strike a deal with my dad. He said to me that I could only start building my car until I'd finished my summer exams, and that only if I secured my place at university would he fund the build. I fulfilled those requirements and got into university, and in fact used my Greenpower experience to help secure my place. So I spent 6 weeks of my summer holidays solid building my first car, Jet, and I was 18 in these photos. Jet went on to have phenomenal levels of success. In the following years, it went on to win 24 out of the 30 races I entered, including 3 national and international finals and the F24 Plus Championship twice. Really, this gave me the confidence boost that I needed that I could become an engineer and prove to the world what I was capable of. So I was introduced to Solid Edge through Green Power. We are actively encouraged to use Solid Edge for our Green Power designs. And I was always looking to improve my car, to maintain or improve my competitive advantage. So I was designing new components to be fitted onto the car. Many of the components were 3D printed, and 3D printing provides a great incentive for students to learn CAD skills. I was unwilling to compromise the designs in my head, so that only incentivized me to use CAD, develop my skills, and achieve the designs that I wanted. In 2014, I was in my second year of university, looking to go on a 12-month internship. I used my Green Power experience, the knowledge that I'd gained, the practical skills, but also the initiative that I'd shown through setting up my own team to secure a 12-month placement at Red Bull Formula One team. Now, in some ways, this is a dream come true. But I say some ways. 2 years ago, I failed to get on an engineering course. I couldn't believe that I was working at the highest level of motorsport. I was a systems design engineer working on the RB10 and RB11 race cars. I was involved in the design and manufacture of the ERS system, the exhausts, the electronics, R&D and pit equipment. I learned a huge amount on my placement, but I was able to transfer my Solid Edge skills straight into the professional environment. Seamless transmission. After my placement, I wanted to take my Green Power racing to the next level. So I decided to build Jet 2. Now, the aim of Jet 2 was to design a car entirely within Solid Edge and to build it to the highest level. Much of the design is similar to my previous car, Jet. But the benefit of having a 3D assembly was I was able to reduce the tolerances, to improve the packaging, to reduce the frontal area, and ultimately reduce the drag. Much of the components were designed in Solid Edge, including the overall surfaces. CFD testing allowed for an iterative design process, and after many different iterations, the design was significantly more efficient than my previous car, Jet. The surfaces were then used to create 3D machined tooling block patterns, and from these patterns, the molds were made into which carbon fiber was laid to produce the tubs. This is just one example of how Solid Edge was directly used to build Jet 2. I raced Jet 2 in the 2015 and 2016 seasons, again with phenomenal levels of success. It won 12 out of the 24 races it entered, and just last week, I won the F24 Plus International Final and the F24 Plus Championship. I'm really proud. Thank you. I'm really proud of what I've achieved through Green Power and Jet 2, and it really cements my belief that I can be a good design engineer. So I'd like to call to action, whether you're a technology partner, a Solid Edge user, or involved in education. I urge you to get involved in Green Power. It has provided me with a perfect platform for my future development. and there are many other students like me that would benefit from the Greenpower Education Program. Thank you very much.